Hope you're having a great day, students. Today we are going to take the topic of area. This is specifically for standard 8. So without further delay, let's begin and come to the topic. I'll be drawing few geometrical structures and I'm sure you will be able to recognize what I'm trying to draw. This is a circle. This is a square. This is a parallelogram. This is a triangle. Okay, now I'm going to ask you to differentiate between the few more structures that I'm going to bring in front of you. Just look at it. These both are circles, but the difference is here only the boundary has been drawn, whereas this circle is completely colored from within. Moving on to the next. Both the structures are square, but the same difference that you can see is this square is colored from within, or it is occupying some particular color from within, that is pink color. It's completely filled and this is completely empty, which means that only the perimeter or the periphery has been drawn over here. When we speak about this parallelogram, same difference which I already showed you, and the triangle, even these, both the structures are triangle, but this is filled within and this is the empty space. So whenever in the data or in the exam, if they ask you to find out the inner space or the inner quantity of a particular object, it means that they are asking you to find out the area. Okay, so today we'll be studying area specifically for two geometrical shapes. One is the square and another is the parallelogram. I'll try to make you understand through some measurements. One more thing, when we speak about measurements, we need to remember that whatever answer we get, we need to put units after that. Okay, so units are very, very important. In case when you have to find the area of a square, you require only one thing. You require only one thing, and that is side, because the formula for area of a square is side square. Okay, we know that all the sides of a square are equal, which means if one side of the square is 4 cm, all the sides are going to be 4 cm. Okay, so in case in the data, if they ask you, you have to find the area of a square and the side is given as 5 cm. So how are you going to find the area? It's very simple. Side is 5. So because it is given side square, it's going to be 5 into 5, 2 times, because square is 2. 5 into 5 will give you 25. But as I told you that units are equally important, we need to look over here. If it is given centimeter, the units are going to be centimeter square. If this would be meter, the answer would be in meter square. So always remember, without writing the units, you are never going to get full marks for that. Okay. Now moving on to the next, that is area of a parallelogram. For parallelogram, I'll just draw this parallelogram and show you what is the height and what is the base. This is the base. Base is always at the bottom and height is this. Okay, so we require two things for parallelogram. One is the base and another is the height. B stands for base and H stands for height. So here in the data, if they give you that the base of the parallelogram is 7 meter and height is 3 meter, find the area of a parallelogram. So the formula for area of a parallelogram is base into height. The base is already given 7, height is also given 3. So 7 threes are gives you 21. The units are meter, therefore meter square. Now use the logic. It's not only because I am saying that you have to write meter square or centimeter square. It's very simple. See, in case if I write over here 7 meter into 3 meter. Let's go step by step. 7 threes are 21. That is clear with the numbers. But what about the units? Meter into meter will give you meter square. That is why we put the unit as square. Always remember. So for area, at the end, whenever you're going to put the units, it's always going to be in square units. I hope this was useful for you. Try to practice this kind of sums. you already have in your textbook. Area is a concept which will be always going on and on till your 10th standard. So it's always going to be useful for you. Okay, have a great day. Take care.